I can speak to you right now, dear one, and I can tell you that I have green skin. And clearly, all of your senses will tell you I do not. All of your memories will tell you that no human being has green skin. And yet some of you may be so eager to escape your own personal reality that you may believe in this false illusion. You may start telling yourself, he has green skin. And when questioned, you will say, simply because it is the truth. He told me he has green skin. And I trust him. He gave me a guarantee that his skin is green. And I believe him. Even when all of your senses, dear one, even when all of your own information tells you something is false, you often believe it as truth because you hear the words spoken in your mind, because you hear the words spoken by another. And so look at your lives, dear ones. How many of you have been in situations of abuse? How many of you have been struck by the hand, by the fist, by the words of another? And then, dear one, the person tells you, I did not mean to hit you. I did not abuse you. You are wrong in your thinking. I did not hurt you. You caused it. It was you who made me do it. How many times, dear one, are you told words that you believe in, and you believe these words over your own personal experience? If another raises his or her hand to you and strikes you down, it is their will and their action that has performed this. You, dear one, cannot control the body of another. You cannot control the mind of another. And yet, they often have you believing this through their twisted words, through their manipulation and lies. But you, dear one, you are the one to blame because you have given truth to their words. You have made true their lies in your own mind. You are the one who is responsible for everything you believe inside yourself. Yes, it is true that this world gives you misinformation, incorrect knowledge. From the time we are born, our ears are bombarded with speech, and much of it is not accurate. But as you awaken as consciousness in this human body and in this world, you will gain the ability to decide. Your free will gives you choice. And this choice extends into your mind. What will you believe to be true? What is your truth? Because that which you believe to be true creates your own reality. If I tell you that I have green skin, you have a choice to believe my words or to discard them as inaccuracies. You need not be emotionally angry with me. You need not argue or fight back. In no way do you need to convince me to change my mind or my speech. All that is needed is that you take control of your mind. Understand this. So many arguments arise because we try to change another. And it begins because we believe what they tell us to be true. If you see me telling you that I have green skin, that is me showing you that I believe this illusion. That is my reality. That is my truth. You do not need to change my truth. You simply need to learn how to create your own. You are not responsible for me. You are not responsible for my words. You do not control my actions or my understanding. In the beginning, dear ones, of many humans' path of awakening, we feel as though we must teach others. We feel as though we must control others. We feel this way. We have these beliefs because we have been controlled. Throughout our lives, we have been told what to think and how to act. It is the only way we know of living. And so as we gain more spiritual awakening, automatically we start to project that upon others. What was projected upon us, we now treat others through. Look at this, dear ones. You have lived an entire lifetime with your reality being given to you. You have been told what to think and how to act, how to speak and how to live. Society has given you these rules. Your parents have given you these rules. The television has given you these rules. And when you awaken, you start to think for yourself. As this opening occurs, often you become very aggressive in trying to change or heal or teach or control others. It is because you have been shown this style of living. You have been controlled, and so you know very little else. Look at our words. They run very deep, for they are designed to break you out of control. They are designed to give you freedom as consciousness right now. You, dear ones, are free to do anything. The desire to control another stems from how society has controlled you. That program is still running within you. When you give yourself complete freedom to act and think for yourself, to do what your heart desires, then you will have no desire to control another. You will want every other person to have this same freedom in themselves. You have discovered your free will, and you see its great value. And so you will hope in the sincerity of your heart that other people find this valuable freedom inside. And so you will not control, but you may guide. And we guide through how we live. We guide through how we express in this world. As it has been said, a picture is worth a thousand words. A picture is the fullness of the experience. It is what you see with your eyes. The experiences of your senses, dear ones, are far more valuable and accurate than the words spoken in your mind. The mind is the resting place of the ego, the subconscious creations of thought that cycle around and around and around, telling you who you are, telling you how to live, telling you you have no freedom, no choice. A picture, dear one, your personal experience is priceless.